What is up, everybody? It's Gorilla Man here, back with another Car Mechanic Simulator video. And in today's video, we are going to be finishing up the 83 Ford Bronco Mark III Police Edition. That is a mouthful to say, but we're going to be finishing this bad boy up today. I think we're doing a V8 overhead valve single carb. Let me pop the hood here and check. Yep, we're going to keep it single carb. I went through and I redid. Crouchy, there you go. I redid the entire suspension. So you guys can see suspension is completely done. I also did the fuel tank and then tires, of course, put back on. But that's it so far. So it is time to pull the engine out, actually. I gotta take the battery. Transfer the crane. All right, we will pull this engine. I don't know if I have any other. See, I have like two engines just chilling, but those are V8 repair. It's a 6P. Can this thing take a 6P? It can't. Okay, but this thing can take a modern V8, which we're not doing. We're keeping it retro. Okay, so we'll do the V8 single carb. Can that thing take a Boss rear wheel drive? It could. We could have used a Boss, but I guess I won't. We've been holding on to this Boss motor for quite some time now. Ever since we done one of the last Mustangs, I think is what it was. And look at that, there you go, engine's torn apart. It's only two pieces, so. Hopefully we can repair the block and everything. It looks like we are able to. All right, there we go. So, just looking at these pieces here real quick. Let me go get a camshaft. Uh-oh. Yeah, let me grab a couple performance pieces here. Camshaft, let's get ourselves. I think I move my mic here. It's blocking my keyboard, I can't see very well. Alternator, it was the regular one. It's a V8. It's going to be a regular alternator. Power steering pump. It's not the F version. No way, it's the F version. Yeah, it's the V8. And then we're also going to grab pistons. 8 of those. Camshaft. We need to grab that one camshaft. This is a single cam. All right, main shop, and then we're gonna do some rod caps. 8 rod caps. Let's grab ourselves some crankshaft caps too while we're at it. 3 of those should do it. Oil pan. Trying to remember what the V8 overhead valve oil pan looks like. We'll go with this one, the Fierte. What else do we need? Oh, piston rings. All right, guys, we missing anything? I think we got a lot. Oh, it's the oil filter. That was the other thing I was gonna snag while we were in there. And then, yeah, we were gonna do a little bit of performance on this. Actually, probably just a lot of performance, probably just everything we can do. Because this is a police car, so, you know, I do want it to be back up to its former glory, because, you know, police cars are, they're decently fast. I mean, they're not the fastest thing on the block, obviously, but they're up there. They're not too bad. Oh, there we go. It wasn't letting me look up there for some reason. Get all these seated into place. There we go. Get our crankshaft bearing caps. I guess we'll start with the center. And get this last one. There we go. I also just realized I have not done a Diesel Brothers video for quite some time now. Still need to finish up that truck we were working on. There we go. And then, guys, for those of you watching this, later today, I will be having a channel update video coming out. Probably just like a 3-4 minute long video, just like describing like my plans for the channel and everything coming up here over the next couple months. I think we're going to start doing Farming Sim again, I think is what it was. That was like one of the big things that I know a lot of you guys are missing out on. And I actually am kind of missing it a little bit because I haven't played it since we stopped playing it. So I might start playing it up again on the channel too. We'll just find out from the video. Oh, we had one left over. Look at that. What do we need for the front here? Can we put the front together? So you need coil B, ignition distributor. I can get all this to performance. Oh, we're not in the right one. There we go, ignition. Coil, distributor, rotor, cap. I think we have all the clips for this too, so. Ah, doesn't match. There we go. I wish it would always just prioritize performance pieces over non-performance pieces. That would make my life so much easier. All right, then we need cam gear and then our timing chain. So let's go in here. It's cam gear for V8 overhead valve. And then we need our timing chain for V8 overhead valve. There you go. They all look the same, have the same model, but some of them don't work. Timing cover. V8 overhead valve. Super simple looking one. Where's it at? There she is. So I usually wait to do timing till after the heads are done, but not today. So we need to get our water pump and a V8 pulley. Where is it? It's the G version? Nope, it's not. Guys, I am blind. I can't see it. Where is it? There it is. Jeez. I was gonna say. All right, I think that should be it. Unless this is a V8. No, this is, yeah. There we go. Thankfully. Pulley on. And then we need our serpentine belts for the V8. Serpentine belts. Overhead valve. So there's A and B's here somewhere. There it is. Then we need our radiator fan. And there we go. There is the front end done. I see, I usually don't do the front end first. So this was very, very different for me. A lot of parts to go into that. All right. Time to get these heads completely done. Heads aren't too hard. So let's see, we need engine head for V8 overhead valve. We can go in here to tuning shop. We'll do this. So we're probably, it's just this, yeah, the normal ones. So two of these. I'm trying to remember if we're gonna need rocker arms and all that. Yep, we will need a rocker arms and the whole shebang. All right, so we need valve push rods. Head valve manifold. Grab two of those. Then we'll go grab our rocker arms. So it's 8 per side, so 16 total. And then we're gonna need the valve push rods, which is another 16 of these, because one push rod per one rocker arm. I can't see very well. There we go. And this last one here. All right, now we should be able to lay down all these rocker arms, throw on our manifold, spark plugs, and then cover. And we should be done with this side. And then we can just flip it real quick, finish the other side. And then we got transmission to do. And then we should be good, and we can pop this back in. I think we do need to get a new, what do you call it? I'm blanking here, what is it called? A new gearbox and drive shaft is what I think we need. Engine head cover B. Oh, no, we don't want to grab these spark plugs. We want the performance ones. There we go. All performance stuff has a little bit of a red on it for some reason. I don't know which wires I need. I don't think it's these ones. It's definitely not those. Or head valve, head cover. We're gonna hope we bought the right one. Hey, we did, thankfully. Yeah, guys, I got quite a few special builds coming up here super, super soon. The next build that we're gonna do is probably going to be the Mach 1 Mustang, just because we've had that one queued up for a hot minute now. And then after the Mach 1, I have, I think it's 6 or 7 more builds planned to go, but I'll let you in on some of them. One of them is going to be a Honda lawnmower. One of them is going to be a Lamborghini tractor. And then we have a few other cars and trucks to work on that are really, really neat. We also picked up 2 more Lamborghinis, if you guys didn't catch that in one of the last episodes. I picked up 2 more Lamborghinis so we can make probably around, push ourselves up to 5.5 mil. Maybe 6, actually, if we're lucky. Let me just say that. And we do the Lamborghinis, as you guys probably know, is to... V8 wires, that's why. We do the Lamborghinis just so we can afford to do all of this stuff that we're doing now and not have to worry about it at all. Just because this stuff costs probably about $45,000 to $100,000 per truck or car, which means with one Lamborghini we can do like 15 to 20 trucks and cars and we're perfectly fine, not running out of money or anything like that, which is super, super, super handy. Mainly because I don't mod my money, so that's another thing. Let's go grab our ignition wires. Oh, I spelled that wrong. There we go. Oh, we already had some. Look at that. Oh, we had a special one. Okay. We'll do the one carb. See if we have... I guess we have a round air filter for a single carb. One carb. Look at that. We got everything purchased right here, except for the carburetor itself. I gotta admit, I'm kind of glad that we don't have to do gaskets in this game. Granted, they would make it a lot more realistic, but it would be a pain in the butt. Holy crap, this carb adds 12% horsepower gain. Oh my lord, that is insane. Get that performance filter on there. Alrighty, looking good. If I could just scroll around to here. Alright, let's grab our flywheels and... Why did I just do CH? Let's grab our flywheel and our transmission parts. Clutch plate. Let's grab our bearing. Alrighty. Make sure we select the correct one. Man, I wish we had some pucked clutches. That'd be pretty cool. I know there's a few of them that are of the appearance of being like puck clutch, like a 6-puck or 5-puck. But I'm pretty sure those ones are only like the, what do you call them? The Porsche motors, I think is what I have them. All right, let's put this sucker in. Oh, baby, what's the value at? 26,000, that's not bad, considering the fact that we're for 4. We did spend quite a, not that much money on the car value, for the motor here. One thing I do like, my dad owns an old C10, and the look of these engine bays is just absolutely amazing to me, just because of how deep they are and how much room there is. It's absolutely ridiculous. Oh shoot, and it wants a fan housing. It's like we got double radiator fans in there then. Oh, there we go. It is looking good. Let me get out of this view. I guess we can't really see very well, can we? Oh, I guess, yeah, we just No. I just took it out. I guess if we lowered the truck about a foot, we could see in there a lot better. All right, let's hook up this the exhaust and gear box here. So let's get our performance. Actually, no, we're not going to do a performance one just because it's not going to... We don't need that, the performance gearbox. Just because, yeah, we won't need it at all now that I'm thinking about it. We're not going to be drag racing this or anything, so you don't need to be adjusting the timing. All right, let's get this drive shaft put into place. And then after the drive shaft, we can do the mufflers and the rest of the exhaust. And I think we're done. We also got to remember to put oil in. That's what we need to do. So we need two rear muffler for V8 overhead valve and a middle muffler. Okay, so rear muffler, V8 overhead valve, two of those. Then we're going to need a middle. I don't know if we need a cat or not, but I'm pretty sure we have two leftover catalytic converters. All right, looks like those hook right up. Is that it? Is that everything? I guess as the we did the interior too, correct? Yeah, we did the interior. Oh, there we go. Now let's just fill this thing up with some good soup oil and we can send her on her way. We will be dyno testing this just because we just gotta dyno test it. We gotta see what kind of horsepower this single carb engine makes. All right, there we go. Everything is at 100% restoration for $6,000. Restoration bonus for $6,000. All right, time to dyno this bad boy. I'm not expecting much out of it. Maybe 600 horsepower. Which is a lot for this. 303. Okay, yeah, maybe we're going with 475. That's the guess. See them all-wheel drive, or that four-wheel drive working very well, I see here. All right, she's squatting. Ah, tapers off pretty quick. Oh, wow. 542% or 542 horsepower and a 78.64% gain in overall horsepower. Not bad. I think torque increased. Yeah, torque increased quite a bit too. But there we go, guys. Here is your, let me move this over to entrance A. Here is your Ford Bronco, or 1983 Ford Bronco Mark III Police Edition complete. There you go, police cruiser. Pushing 542 horsepower. This thing, for what it is, 542 horsepower, that is insane. That's a lot. This thing can 100% cruise. I would definitely not want to see this in my rearview mirror because be a little bit terrifying, especially if you didn't know that this had this much horsepower and somebody tried to get away. Nah, you ain't making it. Alright guys, but thank you all for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video so far, hit that like button. You know, if you like the car, or you like the truck, hit that like button too. I'd greatly appreciate it. If our guys aren't subbed yet, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. I would really appreciate it. But until further ado, I will see you all in the next Car Mechanic Simulator video.